Now then, today in the box, I've got the YOTON YD155 16.9-inch portable DVD player. Now let's give it a go, but first be sure to check my full review below and to press like and subscribe. Now many thanks, and let's get on with it. Let's look inside the box, and here's the DVD player itself, which is 39 by 26 by 5 centimeters and weighs just 1.8 kilograms, which is lighter than some rival DVD players I've tested. On the back is the information card, speaker grills, for some reason they're wall mounts, I'm not quite sure why. On the side is a port bay, which we'll look at in greater detail later on. And I think the build quality is fine. It's quite lightweight, but that's no bad thing for a portable device. Now the on-device controls are fairly basic. They're just for track navigation and to access the menu system, and of course the volume. And that's really all you're going to need. The more advanced controls can be found on the remote control itself, which again we'll look at in more detail later on. So press the slider to open the DVD tray, and the main selling point of this device is just how flexible the screen is. It can be positioned more or less any way, but again we'll look at that once more later on. Now we get a UK power supply, and we get a car power supply, which can be used to run the device in real time or to charge the battery, and there's an RCA cable adapter. Now here's the remote control, which is medium size, and I think it's got too many controls on it. It's a bit complex to use, and there's a user guide, which again is rather basic. Here are some sample pages. Zoom in and pause to read them. The screen can be swiveled 270 degrees right and 180 degrees left. It can also be folded flat, forwards or backwards. It can be put more or less any position. And it's not a bad screen at all, actually. The video quality is good, and the viewing angles are not at all bad. Often portable DVD players have got very low quality screens, but this one is not at all bad for the price. Now here's the port bay. We've got USB-A, SD card, audio out, AV out, AV in, power import, and the gaming USB. Charging is nice and simple. Plug in, the red light lights up and goes out when charging is completed. Now the first time that you use the device, be sure to remove the paper protective card. Now let's get it going and see how it shapes up. It takes a few seconds to read the data from the disc. And as you can see, the screen quality, the picture quality, is not at all bad. There's good colour saturation, good contrast, and highlights are not blown out. It's really not a bad screen at all for the budget price. The remote control works well enough, but it is overly complicated. It's too small for the number of buttons on there, but it does work and gets the job done. You have to just memorize the key buttons that you're going to need. And there are quite a few features that can be accessed from the remote control, including picture zooming, which we'll see shortly, and plenty of others. There's a picture zooming going out, and it can come back in. Now the picture and other features can be finely tuned using the menu settings, which can be accessed either with the remote control or directly from the device itself. Now then, I've tried a few other portable DVD players before and they've all been okay, but all of them have been heavier, larger and bulkier than this one. This one's got a 16.9 inch body with a 14.1 inch LCD screen. The build quality, as I say, is lightweight, but it feels, you know, decent quality. I think it's probably built to last. It's got a rechargeable 5000 mAh battery built in, and it comes with a UK power adapter and a car adapter to recharge your battery or to run your device in real time. It will play DVDs, MP3s, with an SD card port and a USB port. In fact, there are two USB ports. The second one is used to connect this device to another one for some sort of gaming, but how that works, I'm not sure, but it's clearly a thing. And that really is it. The screen quality is okay, not the highest resolution I've seen, but fine for what it is, because really it's designed for use on the go. You can run this in your car, give it to your kids when you're on a car journey or when you're on holiday or whatever. And it's a way of viewing your old DVD collection, because these days modern computers don't come with DVD players. And that really is it. This is a decent quality, lightweight, budget-priced DVD player that works well and won't break the bank, and I think for the price, it's a pretty decent buy.